HKM-TV presents girls varsity basketball, and tonight, here on Think Pink Night, we have a Tri-Valley League battle between the 9-2 Hopkinton Hillers and the 3-9 Dover-Sherborn Raiders. Hi, I'm Tim Haladic here with Steve Spector tonight. And Steve, we've seen this Hopkinton-Dover-Sherborn game once before, and Hopkinton had a big win, 68-24. What do you think Dover-Sherborn's going to try to do different to make sure that doesn't happen today? Yeah.
Well, that's a pretty big spread. It's kind of self-explanatory, and we're going to, you know what? I think they're going to do some announcing right now, so I'll answer that question in just a second, okay?
Classic competition. The league will not tolerate negative statements or actions directed towards competitors, game officials, or fans in attendance. Such actions include taunting, trash-talking, degrading of players, or officials. The Tri-Valley League has adopted a zero-tolerance policy. Warnings will not be issued. Offenders will be ejected. Please respect all decisions made by officials. Please respect fans, coaches, participants, and opponents alike. And now the lines for tonight's game. First, for the Dover-Sherborn Raiders, number 2, junior, Lizzie Jenkins. Number 12, freshman, Olivia Collins. Number 14, junior captain, Kelby Beaton. Number 21, sophomore, Sophia Federico. And number 23, junior captain, Allie Schumann. The Raiders are coached by Katie Klepta, Casey Frazier, and Bob Weiler. And now for your hometown, Hopkinton Hillers. At guard, number 10, senior, Julia Canestri. At guard, number 11, junior, Callie Corby. At guard, number 12, senior captain, Emma Lakasha. At 4, number 31, senior captain, Michaela Pucci. And at 4, number 44, junior captain, Ivy Gogol. The Hills are managed by Haley Grace Neon and Molly Birchman. They're coached by Nick Greco, Kerry Chatton, Kristen Baldiga, and Anthony Gonzalez. Would you please all rise for the playing of our national anthem?
So, back here in the booth, Hopkinton coming in, Steve, winning 6 in a row, Dover-Sherborn losing 3 in a row, and like I said before, the last meeting between these two teams on December 16th saw a Hopkinton victory by the score of 68-24.
Well, yeah, I mean, just looking at the quick roster on paper and also physically, you know, Hopkinton, as it goes for most teams and most of their opponents, they have a significant height advantage, and in this particular case, in addition to the height advantage, they have an experience advantage as well. There's not even a senior on the roster for Dover-Sherborn. You know, in looking at some of their most recent games, they've struggled, to be perfectly blunt. So this you know, not to get ahead of ourselves, this could be an opportunity for some of the players who haven't gotten a lot of playing time as the game goes along. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. We got to take care of business, right?
Right, still got a game to play. And start things off, Canestri with the quick layup. Pucci with her head up finds the cutting Canestri, a quick 2-0 lead.
It took 4 seconds to get a basket, so.
Sophia Federico takes it down the other end for Dover-Sherborn. Too strong off the glass. Now Callie Corby controls it for Hopkinton.
Good to see Callie get a start.
Lakasha takes a step in, fires a three. Bit too strong, but rebounded by Canestrari. Down low to Gogol, and she turns, fires. Good. 4-0 now, Hopkinton.
Yeah, that's going to be just a tough matchup. It's early, and they already are sort of establishing themselves, the Hiller girls are.
Stuck right past the half-court line. Does find help now in the hands of Kelby Whedon. Ball out of bounds now in the Hiller possession.
Michaela Pucci doing a nice job trying to cut the baseline off and cause a turnover for Dover-Sherborn as their player ran out of room down there.
Dover-Sherborn starting things off in man-to-man. Oh, it looks more like a zone now. Started a man, switched to zone. Gogolin down low, fires a bit too strong. Pucci with the rebound. Partially blocked, but she still muscles it through.
Hiller's with a full court pressure defense right out of the gate. Dover-Sherborn did a good job getting through that this time.
Whedon controlling it for the Raiders. Still 6-0. 6.5 minutes left in the first quarter. Federico in trouble, just manages to get it away. Now in the hands of Whedon again. She fires the three, not much time left. Off the front rim, rebounded.
Oh, nice pass.
Nice pass down low. The great fake from Lizzie Jenkins finds Olivia Collins in the post, who finishes the first points of the game for the Raiders.
Yeah, Lizzie Jenkins of Dover-Sherborn making a good heads-up bounce pass. Nice ball fake, got the Hiller girl in the air, and then a nice, cute little pass there for the easy layup.
Lakasha with it at the three-point line. Kicks it over to help. Now Pucci drives, kicks over to Canestrari. She thought about the three and traveled.
I think in the NBA that wouldn't have been a travel, but in the Tri-Valley League, I think they're a little tighter on those situations.
Now Whedon with it again for Dover-Sherborn. Looks to be the primary ball
nice
handler.
Play.
Nice scoop hand layup. She thinks she got fouled. No call from the ref. 6-4.
She's
now
got some speed,
Hopkinton.
Number 14 of Whedon of Dover-Sherborn. That was a nice take.
Now Whedon up in the face of Canestrari, forces the ball away from her. Lakasha drives, kicks it out. Corby for three. Nothing there, and rebounded by Dover-Sherborn. Olivia Collins, the freshman. Federico drives and throws it down to Collins. Nice move
block
from her, but a great block from Ivy Gogolin. Ball rolls out of bounds off of a Hiller. Still Dover-Sherborn ball.
Got some substitutions coming in here. Looks like Lily Morningstar is she didn't play last week,
right,
so
yeah.
And she was on crutches. So it looked like, I believe she was on crutches last week, and it's great to see her on the court tonight.
Traveling there as Kelsey Whedon rolls around on the, Kelby Whedon, excuse me, rolls around on the ground. Another turnover for Dover-Sherborn. And I don't believe that was Morningstar on the crutches.
It wasn't?
The same girl is still there on crutches.
Okay.
I just think she wasn't there
maybe
last
week. Maybe she was
week.
Not. She didn't play. Maybe she was ill. I don't want to make any
right,
speculations,
right.
But it's good to see her on
but
the court.
She looks fine now.
She
so
does. She definitely does. And she's probably going to present some problems for Dover-Sherborn
right.
Based on what we've seen of her in the last year and a half.
If Whedon has any more success driving, I would imagine that's where Morningstar's next assignment would be.
Probably. That's a good call there.
Pass in now to Callie Corby. Starting things off for the Hillers. Again, still a 6-4 lead.
Three seconds.
Offensive 3 seconds. Looks like on Regan Keaveney there.
After a quick start by the Hillers, they've kind of cooled down, and Dover-Sherborn is evened things up almost. Tighten the score up to 6-4.
Well, we saw the Hillers score in the first 4 seconds, and things have certainly slowed down since then. Tough play there as Allie Schulman, the junior captain, tried to wrap around a Hiller defender, ended up stepping out of bounds on the baseline. Now we have a timeout, looks like, from Coach Greco.
Yeah, so they got a few quick hoops, Tim, and then in the last 2.5 minutes or so, they just seemed to be a little out of sync. They had a 3-second call down there, and Dover-Sherborn has kind of gathered themselves a little bit. And, you know, as things inevitably go, you know, when teams play themselves play each other for the second time, mm-hmm. During the season, they know each other a little bit better. So
right.
Dover-Sherborn probably will give the Hiller girls a good game tonight. I think that we're seeing that already.
You can see from up here, looking down at the benches, just the depth difference, not only in terms of experience, but just bodies. So it looks like if Hopkinton can try to drag this one out, maybe they can maybe force them to be more tired than they would normally be and get an advantage that
way,
because you can see the difference.
No question. There's a lot of bodies on the Hiller, a lot of depth there, a lot of experience. And Dover-Sherborn, as you say, there's probably, I only see four substitutions,
but it
definitely seems lighter. And, you know, it's a Tuesday night here in the Athletic Center, certainly not the greatest weather day, so the crowd is a little light mm-hmm. as compared to the last Friday
right,
night
yeah.
doubleheader
rocking, yep.
with Ashland. But this is nevertheless going to be an exciting Tri-Valley League game here.
Speaking of the TVL, the top three in the standings, we have Medfield at number one. They still haven't lost a game yet, as a layup is missed there by Allie Schulman, corralled by Hopkinton. And speaking of Hopkinton, they take second in the TVL, followed by Millis at the third spot. Ivy Gogolin lays it softly off the backboard. Nice play from Gogolin.
Oh, nice. Ooh, good hustle by Lily. Almost got the steal there.
Yeah, there's Morningstar making her presence felt. 8-4 now, 3:55 left.
Looks like Emma Lakasha and Kate Huebner back in the game. Or Kate's in for the first time. She had a really nice game the other night.
Yeah, with Lily out, yep. She had her number called a bit more.
Definitely.
Loose ball. Looked like Olivia Collins had more of the handle on it, but a jump ball called nonetheless. This one awarded to the Raiders.
Hiller's in a man-to-man defense.
Lizzie Jenkins just manages to get it in before the 5-second call. Collins with a shot. Nothing doing there, and rebounded by Huebner. Morningstar open for three, turns it up, fires the jump shot. Nice play by Lily Morningstar. Turned up the good shot and got a better shot and knocked it down.
Exactly, Tim. And, you know, she squared up beautifully, didn't rush the shot. Well done.
Nice bounce pass down low from Allie Schulman. No basket there for Dover-Sherborn, but a nice attempt. Morningstar, good idea with the pass. Sticking a paw out was a Dover-Sherborn player, knocked it out.
Yeah, Olivia Collins, a freshman, got some good size there. She anticipated that pass and broke it up, which was a good thing for them.
Gogolin smothered down low, trying to get something going. Ended up sliding that pivot foot, another travel call on the Hillers.
Yeah, as the game gets along, we'll see how Dover-Sherborn can navigate the height differential. Timeout by the Dover-Sherborn coach, as she anticipated that they weren't going to get the ball in, probably just in the nick of time. Mm-hmm. Head coach is Kenny Slebda.
Klebda.
Yep. Thank you very much.
I know that from my newspaper
days.
Oh,
good.
So.
Thank you. You rescued me there, and I really appreciate
it's
it.
It's all right.
Well, you know, they're hanging around, the Dover-Sherborn yep. Raiders, and to their credit, they're up against, you know, one of the top teams in the Tri-Valley League, and, the, you know, probably going to, you know, the Hiller girls are well-positioned to be a high seed in the tournament
right. Yep.
In a few weeks, and Dover-Sherborn is playing a little bit more for pride than positioning it for the playoffs, but
right.
You know, so far they're giving the Hiller girls a pretty good game, and mm-hmm. we'll see who, you know, with all the girls available for Coach Greco, he's got a lot of choices, and he's rotating
right.
a lot
yep.
of players in. Everybody's looking pretty fresh. Fast forward to the second half, and we'll see how that rolls. But
right.
given some of the differential, the point differentials in some of the Dover-Sherborn games. It'll be interesting to see how long they can hang with us.
Right. And a turnover right there. Morningstar stole it away, but then turned it right back over, trying to fire it in to Ivy Gogolin. Ill-advised pass there. Now Dover-Sherborn looking to get something going. Nice pass from the junior captain, Shulman. Nothing doing on the shot. Now rebounded.
Ooh, unlucky.
Again, miss from Caitlin Murphy. Morningstar open for three. Turns it up to Keaveney, who fires off the side of the rim. Now Lakasha again turned up a three. Tried to throw it inside to Gogolin, but
it's another steal.
To her credit, yeah. Olivia Collins, yeah. Active hands, not letting anything go in there without a battle.
Just a freshman. Pretty big girl. Having a good game so far.
Shot fired and blocked by Keaveney. Rebounded by Jenkins again. Now in the
Kay
hands
Huebner.
Of Huebner.
Nice steal there. Anticipated that.
Keaveney steps up for the three off the pass from Morningstar. Air ball there, rolls out of bounds. Hillers have had a couple of good shots the past few possessions, haven't been able to knock any down. A bit surprising for a team as good behind the arc as the Hillers are.
Yeah, as we've seen, things can happen in bunches, and mm-hmm. we've certainly seen like girls like Julia get hot and
Morningstar, another steal.
Michaela Pucci has the ability to get hot and work the baseline. She's got quite an array of moves down there.
Lakasha with the drive and floater. Can't finish. Pucci.
Oh, nice play.
With the offensive rebound. Absorbs the contact. Can't finish, but will be shooting too.
She's a tough matchup. Very strong down there. And in that particular case, she used her body really well. A little quick ball fake. Got the Dover-Sherborn girl in the air. And then Michaela just leaned into her, drew the foul, almost got the basket.
First free throw off the front iron. I believe that was the first free throw of the game for the Hillers.
I think you're right. Lily's taking a little break, and we
beat
have
me to it.
Yep, and then Julia's back in the game, I think.
Second one, no good for Pucci. Ball bounced off the leg of Caitlin Murphy. Referee did not see it. Awards it to the Dover-Sherborn Raiders.
Are you questioning the refs?
I would
Vision?
Never. I would never.
That's a first, right?
Ball stolen away again.
Smothering press there by the Hiller girls. And
the Hiller defense has forced a lot of turnovers, but on the other hand, they can't really take advantage because they keep turning it back over themselves. Olivia Collins has been a big reason for that.
Haley Gladstone, a sophomore guard, diminutive body type, cleared out the Hiller girl right in front of the ref, but she's really not a big kid, mm-hmm. but certainly clear, you know, the left hand was at full extension there. Got the offensive foul, unfortunately for her.
Keaveney turns around, fires a shot, the first bucket for either team in the last several minutes. Now 12-4 lead for Hopkinton. Stopping with the jump stop, Lizzie Jenkins, from just outside the free throw line, can't hit. Keaveney fires up to Huebner, loose ball, knocked around several times, and last off Dover-Sherborn.
Allie Schumann with a good hustle play from Dover-Sherborn, the captain, junior.
Looks like Tara Raftery will make her first appearance in the game for Dover-Sherborn.
Oh, nice play.
Canestrari takes the contact off the nice pass. Can't finish, but again, two more free throws coming up for Hopkinton.
Looks like some sort of a rotation play coming out of the inbounds for the Hillers, and Julia got really good position on the Dover-Sherborn girl, got in front of her and got a nice pass, and then she got hacked pretty good, so she's on the line for two.
First one good for Canestrari. Hillers now one of three from the line. Second one off the back iron, no good, but Canestrari gets it back.
She got hit there again, I think. but it's early, so I'm going to hold back on the animated, you know, commentary for now. For now,
no chairs flying onto the court yet.
Not yet.
Sorry, it's early in the night. We got time.
And one. There we go.
Michaela Pucci off the nice pass from Emma LaCascia finds an opening again, absorbing contact, this time converting now for the old-fashioned three-point play.
That's Michaela's game again, just like similar to the play a minute or so ago. She drew the contact, anticipated it, and in this particular case, she hit the shot, so that was great.
Free throw does not find the mark. Another rebound there from the freshman Collins. Raftery with it now, kicks it over. Shot fired. Federico can't find the mark. Now grabbed by Pucci. And a quick foul there called on, looks like, the freshman Collins. seconds left. Hiller's enjoying an 11-point lead right now, up 15-4, and have not committed a foul yet.
And that's a big discrepancy in the foul department. Six fouls to zero. And next foul puts the Hillers in a one-and-one situation for the rest of this first half. 10 seconds left in the quarter.
Hillers have been very pass-happy, turning up shots. That time, Canestrari stops and pops, nothing but net on the three. And Federico cannot get the shot off in time. Now Hopkinton up 18-4 after the first.
Well, that's kind of, you know, based on what we recited earlier as far as some of the most recent scores and and games for both teams, 18-4 is not a surprise, I guess. But in that particular case, Julia, who we've seen her get real hot and is capable of, you know, hitting a bunch of barrage of three-pointers. Yep. There was one of them, and that was a backbreaker for Dover-Sherborn right before the quarter end. She nails this three-pointer, but, you know, and her release on that was great. She didn't rush it. She knew she had some time, and pretty comfortable lead for us, right? Doesn't look like we're looking at a fantastic finish here, you know?
No, not quite, but still good to see that the Hillers aren't overlooking this type of opponent in preparation for their big game against undefeated Medfield at Medfield this coming Friday. So it's good to see that they're so focused on the task at hand and are looking to finish off the Raiders here tonight.
Well, I think, this is it's good to have, you know, the crowd starting to fill in a little bit here. Certainly an opportunity for lots of players to get some playing time and, you know, a good preparation for Friday night. Again, we still have the majority of the game tonight to deal with. And this Tri-Valley League's got a lot of good teams, so we'll and the Hillers are one of them.
Right, if not the best, we'll see who can claim that title for the time being at Medfield on Friday at 6:30. But again, for now, we still have three quarters of a game left, and Morningstar will inbound to start the second. 18-4 lead for Hopkinton. And a quick double dribble call there on Corby. She didn't look like she agreed with it. But she's not the referee, so play goes on. Dover-Sherborn ball now. And almost another turnover. Morningstar just hounding Allie Schulman. Knocked out of bounds, still Dover-Sherborn ball. Raftery stuck with it. Now gets it inside to Collins. She is hacked by Gogolin. Two free throws coming up for the Dover-Sherborn freshman.
It's a pretty good play by the Raiders. And Olivia Collins having a pretty good game despite the score differential. Mm-hmm. She's got a few steals. And
it would be a lot higher if she wasn't in there making the plays.
I think you're right.
First free throw just bounces out for Collins. Second one off the front of the rim. Gogolin rebounds and fires it out to Morningstar.
Oh, nice play by this. Nobody helped out Lily there.
No one gave her a call, yeah. And Federico popped right up behind her and just took it away from Lily. Gogolin playing tough defense, and Collins out of the three-point line. Driving is the
nice
captain,
play.
Allie Schulman, who takes a contact and knocks down the floater. First bucket for Dover-Sherborn in the last several minutes.
Really nice play. She went to the hoop strong, created the contact, but it was clearly a foul on the Hiller player, and she has a chance for a three-point play.
No good on the free throw, so still an 18-6 lead. Morningstar thought about the three, drives, throws it down to Gogolin. Awkward looking shot, doesn't find the mark. And Pucci, they're going to say, gets the rebound and then draws a foul on the floor.
She'll be 1-1, if I'm not mistaken.
And it looks like that's one of the referees is saying.
Yeah, it's the seventh foul, so Mikhail's on the line. I mean, the Hillers, it's a 12-point deficit for the Dover-Sherborn Raiders at the moment. And, again, the way the game's going, Dover's hanging in there pretty good,
right.
Dover-Sherborn. Good to see some free throws starting to go down here because that's one aspect. Again, if nothing else, you work on things during these games, and free throw
right.
shooting, they didn't start off very well, but Michaela's hopefully going to nail a couple, which she did.
20-6 lead now, just over 7 minutes remaining in the first half. Oof. Foul looks like on the floor as Kelby Whedon fired up a long floater.
Well, Lily Morningstar with a blocking foul. She was just basically running with the Dover-Sherborn player. The Dover-Sherborn player clearly created the contact, but Lily didn't have her feet set, so it was a foul on Lily in that play.
Canestrari gets her arms in there, almost takes it away. Pucci gets her hands on another pass. And now it looks like a pushing foul on Tara Raftery. Another loose ball foul. Now the Hillers take over.
It's a 1-1 situation again here. Makes for a long half of a game. It's 6:47 left in the half. Hiller's up 20-6. And Dover-Sherborn is up in the foul department. They have 8 fouls to 3 for the Hillers. So
first one good for Pucci. Now she's 3-3 from the line. 3-4, I believe.
And as we've seen, Tim, for a lot of teams, free throw shooting can be contagious, both ways. And it's nice to see a few free throws going down. Spoke too soon there.
Well, it looks like, based on what we've seen so far, the Hillers are going to be spending quite a lot of time there, so they better get used to it. Ivy and Morningstar playing great defense at just past half court line, creating a lot of trouble for the Dover-Sherborn ball handler. And now a DS pass goes off of a Hiller leg. Still Dover-Sherborn ball under the Hiller hoop, 6:30 left. Federico looking to get it in, does manage to find the freshman Collins. And she swings the ball right into the hands of Canestrari, who latches onto it.
For some of the younger players, Olivia Collins, she's only a freshman, having a great game. She, for a big girl, she brought the ball down to a better spot where the guards can grab it, and that's what just happened there. So
Collins in trouble now, looking for a teammate, finds Federico, 1 second left. Could not get the shot off, would not have mattered anyway. Travel violation called. Great defense there from the Hillers.
Swarming. They don't really care what the score is. They get the intensity meter at 10 right now, playing defensively.
Canestrari drives, blocked from behind. Great block from Kelby Whedon. Just taps it out of Canestrari's hands, and now the Raiders take over. Federico drives baseline, tries to find Raftery, cannot, and Pucci wins with her hustle. Takes it the whole way, up and in with the layup.
Nice play.
Great play from Michaela Pucci. And you're right, a timeout from Dover-Sherborn. Michaela Pucci and Tara Raftery were both running towards the ball. Raftery didn't quite give it 100%, and that's what Pucci's known for. And she takes away and makes a layup out of it.
She took advantage of that opportunity. Like, she has a nose for those situations. Saw
the 50-50 balls.
Yep. Exactly. And she's racking up some points here in the first half. I've lost track, but she has a couple of baskets and a few free throws. So this close to 10 points in that range, maybe 8 or 10 points for her. And
sounds about right.
You know, lots of players getting in and out of the game so far for the Hillers, and I'm not sure what the Dover-Sherborn coaches have for a strategy adjustment, but, you know, it's really an uphill battle right now, but, you know, I'm sure they're going to come out and continue to fight. You know, they're trying to deal with the pressure of the Hillers on, like, the full court presses, and I'll say they've done quite well there. Their shots aren't going down so far. And, you know, that's a result of the swarming defense and the significant height advantage that the Hiller girls have.
Absolutely.
So that combination is pretty tough.
Well, if the Dover-Sherborn Raiders do come back, it will not be for a lack of effort on the Hillers' part. They are, like you said, they are still doing that full court press. They just backed off a little bit right now, but up until now have been just harassing the ball carrier, whoever it might be, for Dover-Sherborn. Kelby Whedon drives, tries to get it down low to Raftery. Goglin sticks her hands in there and knocks it out of bounds. Still DS ball.
Hillers in the man-to-man.
Federico does get it into Collins, looking for help. Raftery almost throws it away.
5 seconds on the shot clock.
Collins with it at the three-point line. Raftery stuck now, 2 seconds left. And Morningstar comes up with a steal right before the shot clock goes off. Turnover either way for Dover-Sherborn. Keaveney, nice move,
play.
Steps inside. A nice drop set, gets by Collins and lays it up.
It's Kevin McHale, like, she even has Kevin McHale's number for some of your old-timer on Hillerland that remember the 80s Celtics. But that was an up and down, you know, nice use of her pivot foot there, and found herself with a nice angle to the hoop, and she took advantage of it.
Now Keaveney on the defensive end. Down on the floor, up for a steal. Huebner gets a pass from Morningstar, drives, takes the foul. Great play by Huebner. Seeing Ashley in defense on its heels, decides to take it to the hoop, see what she can get, and ends up with two free throws.
Yeah, she took it right into the pressure, and I'm not sure who the foul was. It looks like number two, Lizzie Jenkins. And Huebner, really nice player. She's got two shots.
We don't have our player foul thing here today on the scoreboard. It's always been nice to have that recently.
That's helpful. We'll have to have a word.
Mr. Trojan, I believe.
I think, I don't know who's in charge of that, but we're going
we'll have to
shake some people down at halftime on that. Could be Mark Sandborn down there. But I don't want to mess with him. He's about 6'8".
He is big.
And a heck of a nice guy, good coach. Hoppington legend here, the Sandboard family. Mitch and Lou and all the kids, outstanding athletes.
Good to see him still involved with the Hiller program.
Yep, definitely.
26-6 lead now for the Hillers. Huebner and Goglin applying backcourt pressure. Just over 4 minutes
remaining.
Number 10
is just wide open over there, but they don't see her. Whoops.
Raftery takes a couple of steps out of bounds, trying to drive baseline. And Dover-Sherborn has been trying to utilize the baseline here, but the Hillers are doing a great job of preventing that, and have forced several turnovers thus far. Lakasha had an open three, turned it up. She's open again. This time won't turn it up. Knocks
it
down. Emma Lakasha. I think she realized her mistake that time, knew she had to knock that one down.
Again, she really set herself well. She had the time, didn't rush the shot. Great release.
Gladstone with it at the three-point line. Now down low to Collins. Loose ball. Looks like a reach-in foul on Ivy Gogolin.
Yep. Boy, the coach of the – can you please pronounce the coach of the Dover-Sherborn?
It's Connie Klebda.
Coach Klebda. She – every time there's a substitution for the Hillers. Oh, that's a nice play right there by Olivia Collins, the freshman. I think it's she got the old-fashioned three-point play opportunity. But, you know, you take Ivy out and you put in Julia, you know. You take out a six-footer, you put in another six-footer.
Right. It doesn't get any easier.
That's just, you know, head-scratcher if you're the other team.
The and one no good for Collins there. Now Hopkinton whizzing the ball around the three-point line. Akasha drives. Baseline to Canestrari. She turns around and shoots. Not enough on that one. Offensive rebound goes to Hillers though. Canestrari again from long range. Oof. Knocks it down. She's not afraid to shoot it.
Well, like I said earlier, she can get into a rhythm and she can be unstoppable. It's fun to watch.
Not if you're a Dover-Sherborn fan.
That's
I
true. For, if you're a Hiller, yep.
Another loose ball and another jump ball as the Hillers have forced many of those. See, I've seen a bit more intensity. Not that they ever haven't been intense before, but now there's people rolling on the floor. We have full court presses, even up 24 points. Maybe Coach Greco has lit a fire under this team in preparation for some of the tough games they have coming up.
I think you might be onto something there, and you know you don't want to just take the pedal off the gas no matter what the score,
right?
And stay true to the game and the integrity of the game and playing. But boy, this is getting to be quite a spread here.
Mm-hmm. As Keaveney misses the three-point shot there. Now in the hands of Haley Gladstone. Kelby Whedon drives baseline, draws the foul there from Keaveney on the floor. Foul's starting to even up a little bit. It
there
was 8-3 at one point.
Yeah, it was 6-0 at one point,
yep.
Too.
Mm-hmm. Can't imagine there's that big of a discrepancy, even if we are rooting for the Hillers up here. Almost a 5-second call.
Ooh,
getting the ball in bounds.
Close.
Hillers doing a great job of preventing that easy dump in. Knocked it out of bounds. Now the Raiders will try to get it in once more. Collins has the ball stripped away.
Ooh, that's a double dribble. That's too bad. I saw it from here. I think he had a call before I told him about it. But
right, because we are connected on their headset.
Oh, that's true. But Kate unfortunately put two hands on the ball in that one dribble, tried to be as inconspicuous as possible, but not enough.
1:40 left in this first half. 32-8 lead for Hopkinton. Looks like an offensive foul called there on Dover-Sherborn.
Kelby Whedon, captain.
She looks a bit frustrated, if not perplexed. Does not like that call. Now the 10th foul for Dover-Sherborn here. Canestrari drives, does not get the kind roll, and rebounded by Lizzie Jenkins. Nice pass down low from the captain. Kelby Whedon finds Olivia Collins, the freshman.
Nice finish.
Canestrari on the other end drives and takes the foul from Collins. Two shots coming up for the senior.
That was a nice, I mean, the score aside, you know, Julia did a nice job taking the ball to the hoop, and Olivia Collins, I don't know how many fouls she has. Can't tell from here.
Right.
That might be her second, but and she's really their only, you know.
Spark, for lack of a better
word.
Well,
this is their first time coming out of the game, as I can, if I'm not mistaken, with a minute left in the half, and she's had a really nice first half, but that was almost a must foul. Julia had an open layup there without her stepping into the lane. Julia knocks down that second one.
Now a minute left for Dover-Sherborn to try to whittle down this 23-point deficit. Three-point shot from Whedon, no good.
Nice control by Lily.
Lakasha fires down low to an open Corby. Her shot, no good. But Morningstar gets in there for the offensive rebound to Kanashari, wide open. Lucky for Dover-Sherborn, that one did not find the mark because Kanashari had no one in front of her. The coach threw her hands up in disgust, it appeared, but luckily no basket there. And now Morningstar on the defensive end, getting her hands in another passing lane. Just 24.6 seconds remaining in this opening half. Again, the Hillers up 33-10. Now it looks like Colleen Doyle in the game for the first time. A ball rolls out of her hands, out of bounds. Now the Hillers have 20 seconds left, no shot clock. Corby with it up top, just looking to dribble out the remaining. Now's time to
somebody's
do something.
Shoot it.
Corby with it. 1 second left, Lakasha from three. No good off the backboard. And the Hillers will take a 23-point lead, up 33-10 into the halftime.
Wow, I'll tell you, that's kind of what we talked about before the game. Not really a surprise with the scoring. And right. I'll tell you what, you know, some of the most valuable people here tonight are our producers and directors and graphics people, so let's mention them real quick. So the producers, John Rich and Mike Tiger Tarosian. I'm making that name up for Mike. Good job there, buddy. Tom Ding's directing. Samantha Ding's doing the graphics, and the camera folks are Mary Arnott, John Rich, and Mike Tarosian, again, doing double duty tonight. I don't know how he does it, but we're having fun. Hillers are in a good spot for the moment, and we're going into halftime with a 23-point lead.
Right, the first game we saw a 68-24 victory for the Hillers, and it looks like we are pretty close to matching that total here tonight. We'll see what happens, what unfolds in the second half. We'll be back in a few minutes.
What it takes.
Will you make a difference? adventure.
Police and fire working together.
Utilizing the latest technology.
Do you have what it takes?
All right, we are back here in the booth. A few moments left until we get started with the second half. Hillers will open up the third quarter with a 33-10 lead. And Steve, it looks like things are primed to keep going in the Hillers' way.
Well, sure. I mean, if you look at the both ends of the floor, defensively, the Hillers holding, doesn't matter what team you're playing, 10 points
right.
and a half is really pretty impressive.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Dover hit some good shots. They had a few shots going in and out, and, you know, they just don't have the firepower, as you would expect as the score dictates.
Mm-hmm.
And, again, what happens in the second half, if the trend continues, it's always great to see some of the players who don't get as much playing time. It's a really good opportunity for them, maybe in the fourth quarter to or sooner, who knows. But certainly when the game gets further along, we'll hope to see some more players in there. Oh, that was. I think there was a little bit of a. Did you get a feeling that am I shooting at the right hoop moment?
That's what it felt like. Collins had an open attempt there, and right before she went up, looked like there wasn't enough defense. So look, she thought maybe I'm not shooting at the right basket. In any event,
and in addition to that, Tim, it looked like the Hillers weren't sure what they were defending. So I think it threw Olivia. Collins off a little bit. She had complete.
It threw me off too.
I didn't
know what to announce.
It was a bit confusing there, and I think there was a quick timeout. 19 seconds in. That's an unusual situation. Maybe mm-hmm. the coaches are saying, "Hey, we're shooting at this basket,
and we
go that way." But I'm not sure who called that timeout. But one of the coaches saw something that it just did not like. And you know, if Dover-Sherborn's going to have any kind of a chance to get in, they're gonna come out with guns a-blazing, as they say, right out of the gate here in the second half to make this a game. We'll see if that happens.
Yeah, we haven't seen too many three-pointers yet from Dover-Sherborn. Looks like they're going to have to start utilizing that if they want to get closer. And that is not
like
a good way to
tipped.
Start.
Yeah, it was, you know, I even saw that, and being the credible and honorable guy that I am, that went off of a Hiller player. I think it was Emma. Got her hand on the ball. Oh, wait a minute.
Yep, no love, it looks like, for the Raiders here.
I'm
as
not
the
sure
ball's
what
awarded
happened there.
To Hopkinton. Canestari drives and takes the awkward layup and finishes.
That's a tough play. Hardly had an angle. But found the angle and kissed it off the backboard.
Federico takes the jump shot just outside the free throw line. No good. Rebounded by Gogolin.
Give and go.
And Pucci takes a nice slap across the face. As she goes up with a layup, can't finish the shot, but is rewarded with two free throws.
Yep, Lizzie Jenkins got her money's worth on that one. Body, you know, bodies collided, elbow or forearm to the head, but Michaela's toughed that one out, and she's got two free throws. Go in and out.
Second one is
nice.
Good for Pucci. 36-10 now. Corby comes up with a steal.
Oh, nice pass.
Gogolin down low. Gets the soft touch. Another 2 points for Hopkinton. It's Corby with a steal again. Tried to fight Gogolin. Bit too hot on that pass. Out of the grasp of Gogolin. Now Dover-Sherborn takes back control.
Hiller's in a full court press. Almost unfair, but that's just, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a third-grade rec ball.
Pass looks like right to Gogolin. She misses the open layup. Maybe she was shocked. She got that pass right to her. In any event, she is fouled.
Looks like Lizzie Jenkins again. She's got two quick fouls. Timeout by.
Another timeout. This one looks like, yep, Dover-Sherborn. Coach Klubbeck cannot be happy. You're not going to be able to come back against a team if you can't even pass it to your own team. So clearly upset there on the sideline.
Yeah, it's just a tough situation. They've got a whole half of basketball to go here. They're down by 28 points, just about 7 minutes left in the third quarter. And the Hillers, no mercy, as they say, mm-hmm. with the full court press. And to some extent, you know, the coach wants to work on some of those things, Coach Greco.
Right.
So it's an opportunity to do that. You can do that in practice, but it's a little more effective to do it in the game.
Right. Nothing replaces experience.
Exactly. So we'll see how relentless he mm-hmm. he continues with that, and he looks like he is. They're setting up another full court press. I'm a compassionate guy. I feel bad. I'm feeling bad for the Raider girls at the moment, just for a moment. Not completely, but you know.
Yeah, personally, I kind of like seeing the Hillers come out with the same intensity, because a lot of times, I don't know, at any level of sports, you see if a team comes out with a lead, they kind of set back on the pedal and allow them to get back in, and the Hillers just simply aren't allowing that to happen.
Exactly. And Ivy's got two
free throws. Free throw's still a concern, though. They have missed a decent number tonight.
We don't have the statistics, but they're probably shooting around 50%.
I would say so, yep.
And there was 0 for 2 there, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm. Federico now brings it up for Dover-Sherborn. A break for them after no free throws went in there.
It's a foul on number 23, looks like.
Canestrari again getting her hands in. Another turnover. Draws the foul.
Allie Schumann with a close to a mugging there, but it was definitely a foul.
Corner three, no good for Canestrari. Rebounded, though, by LaCascia. Another Hiller offensive rebound.
Good ball movement by the Hillers. Plenty of time in the shot clock.
Ball now inside to Pucci. She drives, puts her head down, can't quite muscle it in, gets a rebound, and does put it up and in to Kayla Pucci.
Boy, she's tough
matchup. Her calling card, those offensive rebounds.
She just uses her body so beautifully, mm-hmm. you know, just she gets
as
a hand in the ball there.
She knocks the ball out, yeah.
Really good athlete.
She's not the biggest girl, but she uses her body, I think, more effectively than a lot of people I've seen.
Yeah, she knows how to clear
Clear
the players out and all legal and create shots for
just
herself.
Plays tough.
Yep.
Now that lead up to 30. 40 to 10 now with a few seconds or just past six minutes remaining now in the third quarter. Kelby Whedon tried to get the bounce pass into Collins. A bit too hard on that one. And the ball goes out of bounds. Another Raider turnover.
Callie Corby coming out for Lily Morningstar. That's a serious depth going on there. They go 8-9 deep easily. No drop off.
Turnover there from the Hillers. Corralled by Gladstone. Nice drive and shot there from Kelby Whedon. She takes the tough foul there from Morningstar.
Quite a collision. She's looks like to be a pretty tough athlete. Mm-hmm. She's got some speed. Has a little bit of an edge to her, mm-hmm. her game. I don't know about in real life, but on the court, she has a little
right.
bit of an edge.
Mm-hmm. First free throw bounces around. Trickles out. Second one off the front rim. Keaveney fires from three, Oof. Knocks it down. The assist from Morningstar.
Unselfish. Morningstar had an open three, but mm-hmm. she saw Regan with a sort of a little more space, and Regan, she stepped into that beautifully. Nice finish.
Driving was Gladstone. She tried to dish it off. But a reach in there and a foul from Emma LaCascia prevents that. And the Raiders will inbound under the Hiller hoop. As Gogolin and Canestrari take a break. Allie Mafior in the game for the first time. The senior guard. Driving with the floater was Whedon, no good. Looks like a foul called on the loose ball against Regan Keaveney, I believe. And now the Raiders will inbound again.
It's a good guess. We're looking for the stats on the score.
Right.
don't have the technology quite yet, but we're doing the best we can up here. Oh, nice
Huber
steal.
Huber with the steal. Now bringing it up court. And Morningstar turns that one over.
Nice steal by Lizzie Jenkins. She anticipated the pass, or sort of telegraphed the pass on Lily's part.
And now Huebner, another steal as she took it away from Kelby
play.
Whedon.
Good decision to slow the ball
Huebner
down right there.
Huebner open for three, wide open. Just off the front of the rim, gets her own rebound, puts it
beautiful.
Up. And in the kind roll for Kate Huebner.
She's a scrappy player,
getting
really
a
nice.
Reward for that hustle play right
definitely.
There.
She didn't get boxed out.
Yep.
Dover-Sherborn
ran
player.
Right after her own shot.
Exactly.
That's what they teach you. And Huebner took advantage. As Akasha picks up another reach and foul. A bit too aggressive there. Now Corby and Marissa Prawl will enter the game. Prawl's first appearance in this contest.
With a 35-point lead, 4 minutes and 13 seconds left in third quarter, that's a good decision by Coach Greco.
Apparently that's enough for him.
Yep.
Whedon stuck with it. Hopkinton swarming the ball. Collins makes a nice effort to get to the hoop. Can't get a shot up, but is fouled.
25. Marissa Prawl getting her name in the score sheet with a foul there. Hopefully she'll get her in the box score with some points too.
Whedon dribbling a lot here, looking for something. Rejects the pick from Collins. Now finally gives it up.
Not too bad.
And goes right off the hands of Haley Gladstone. Looks like a bit of frustrated dribbling there from Whedon. Not much going her team's way today. As Federico replaces Whedon and she takes a seat. Coach looks like having a little discussion.
A little heart
her.
To heart there.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe like pass the ball a little bit. But like you say, she's got a little street ball game to her. She looks frustrated, unfortunately,
right.
for her. But, when you that's just a huge spread here.
Tough.
It's tough for the announcers, too, with such a big point spread. But we're doing the best we can. We're having some fun. I'm just trying my best to keep you under control, Tim. So.
Hey, easier said than done, right?
Exactly.
Now Collins with it at the three-point line. She's stuck looking for help. Does find it. Now she gets it back on the other side. Shot up. Draws the foul again. Big point discrepancy here, but Collins, the freshman, still fighting.
Boy, only a freshman. She's got game. She's got another 3 years after this.
Yep.
She's probably going to have quite a career here for Dover-Sherborn, and it looks like she's got some big skills.
Mm-hmm. First free throw off the front rim. 45-10 lead with 3:10 left in the third quarter. Hopkinton looking to improve to 10-2 overall and 10-1 in the TBL. Ahead of that big matchup against Medfield on Friday, Dover-Sherborn looking to avoid going 3-10 and also 2-7 in the TVL.
Nice block by the freshman, Olivia Collins, on Keaveney. That's a pretty nice play. And she takes a rest and can't tell who just came in the game here. Let's see who that is. Number 45, and we don't have that.
Yeah, we do not have her number here.
And she takes a shot,
name.
And we'll have to try to work on that,
of course,
ladies and gentlemen.
She fires a shot right away, right? Looks like there are two players on the Hiller bench that aren't normally on the roster. We'll see if we can get those names for you at some point. And it looks like number 45 is Ashley McDermott as she makes her first appearance in the game and comes in firing.
And why not?
Right.
Looks like a big, she's got some height, playing aggressively.
And correct me if I'm wrong, but is Elizabeth Liberta on the bench there today?
She is, and you know what, she has an injury. She looks like she might be hurt too.
Foul there on McDermott.
Looks like there's a couple of girls with injuries for the Hillers.
Right.
And maybe they brought up a JV player, number 45 here, mm-hmm. Ashley McDermott, which is always a nice feeling to be pulled
right.
up to the varsity.
Yeah. And today's the game to play, up 34. Still in the third quarter here.
Haley Gladstone, sophomore.
She knocks it down.
Dover-Sherborn's in a 1-1 situation with the Hillers having 7 fouls so far in the second half.
Now it looks like the opposite here. We had the Hillers with the big foul discrepancy there in the first half. Now Dover-Sherborn reaping the benefits. Second free throw, no good for Gladstone. Still a 45-12 lead for Hopkinton. Just over 2:30 left now in the third quarter. Callie Corby stuck with it behind the three-point line. 5 seconds left to get something done. Pass knocked away by Lizzie Jenkins. Now it looks like Tara Raftery and Colleen Doyle will enter the game for Dover-Sherborn.
4 seconds to get a shot off here.
Mafior drives, floater, no good.
That's a good shot.
Good effort from Mafior, cannot get the kind of bounce. Now Jenkins has it for the Raiders.
Good defense by Corby.
Raftery inside to Collins. She moves around. Nice footwork. And on the shot is fouled. Two more free throws coming for the freshman.
Well, we've been mentioning her name a few times.
Yep.
And again, in that particular play, she did a couple ball fakes, but she does tend to carry the ball a little low.
Yeah, she likes to swing it through.
Yep. She'll hopefully get some coaching over there and get that squared away.
Can't have that swing low. That allows little guys like me to stick their hands
exactly.
in there and knock it away. We like it when you bring it down low. It's the only way we can get it.
Unlucky.
Yep. No good on the two free throws. Oh, it looks like Lauren Hamm is in the game for the first time as well for Hopkinton. McDermott over to Hamm. She fires the three just off the back rim and corralled by Jenkins.
It's good ball movement by the Hillers. Got a good shot. Hit the back of the rim, not bad.
And it looks like a turnover there. Bounce pass from Haley Gladstone goes out of bounds. And it looks like we have another JV call up here. Number 21, we'll try to get her name for you as well. But I can't imagine that this particular lineup has played very much together, if at all, in a game.
Yeah, hard to say.
Definitely some worthwhile experience, though.
It's just a good opportunity for some of the younger players, future of the Hiller hoop team.
Looks like the name for number 21 is Livy Gladdew. So thanks to our team for helping us out there.
Tom Ding's keeping us in line. Appreciate it, Tom. Okay.
Looks like we have to thank our Hopkinton Hiller cheerleaders for that one. feeding us information. We appreciate it.
Well, Libby, glad to. Good player and really impressive socks. They're very distinctive. Can't help but notice those green and white striped socks. Don't know what the dress code is. If there's any you know, in the NFL you do something like that,
right,
you might be
fined. I don't think she has the money for that.
But nevertheless, really impressive socks.
Making a statement.
I'm sure she has a good game, too, so we'll find that out soon enough.
Air ball on that free throw, a violation on Dover-Sherborn.
Good sportsmanship by the Hiller crowd, not shouting air ball, given the score situation.
I would hope so, yep. That they wouldn't. Mafior turns
well,
around.
Lots of contact
into
there.
Into the hands of Collins.
Boy, I felt that contact up here. There was something had to be called there, but again, I'm gonna go easy because the score differential is 33 points.
Personally, I thought Collins had stayed up that one. It was hard contact. True.
Yep.
It looked like Collins was straight up, but no call. And now Collins has it on the baseline. Fighting for it, though, is McDermott. And that ends the third quarter. Hiller's up 45-12.
Well, geez, I don't know what to say except it was I want to say it was 40 to 10 at half or
similar,
something
yeah.
like that. I'm sorry, I don't have the exact score,
but
it was what I do recall with at my age I'm starting to fade a little bit in my memory, but the Hillers had 10 points, gave up 10 points. That Dover-Sherborn get 2 points that quarter, so just tough D.
Yep.
And we have a 50-50 raffle, and it looks like a relative of, I'm just guessing, of Michaela Pucci, because the last name is Pucci.
I did hear that, yeah.
And could be her mom, I'm just guessing. And she's got some loot from the 50-50 raffle, so we'll be meeting her over at Cornell's after the game for some. She's buying, so no, I'm just kidding.
Does some of that money go to Michaela, or is that against the rules here? Impermissible benefits?
Michaela? I don't know. Well, hopefully it goes to a good cause. You know what? Any parent of a player, any cash payout for all the time they put in.
Right.
If you add up all the youth basketball and AAU, you know, that's a small token of our appreciation for paying a little bit of stipend to the parents. Not a bad situation. Oh, the class of 2019, thanks to the class of the Hoppington class of 2019 for conducting that 50-50 raffle.
And the Hillers still with a bunch of
nice
bench
pass.
Players out here, still have great ball movement. Coach Greco really just instilling that attitude into whoever's out there on the court. As a rebound was grabbed by, I believe, Tara Raftery of Dover-Sherborn, but she was on the end line. So
look there.
Awarded to the Hillers. Bledu with it at the top of the key. Mafior inside.
Nice move.
Nice move, and getting the and one is Ashley McDermott. Great play off the pass from Allie Mafior.
That's a big play.
McDermott put her head down, absorbed the contact, got the bucket to fall. Now her first free throw of this contest.
That was a really nice move. She had a ball fake and finishes the three-point play, feeling good about herself, as she should. That was a heck of a play.
48-12 lead now with just over 7 minutes left in this fourth quarter. Loose ball grabbed by Prawl. She takes it the whole way. Nice move inside.
Ooh.
Can't finish on the layup. Mafior gets the board but is rejected on her attempt. Raftery down the court for Dover-Sherborn. Finds Collins, who races to save it from going out of bounds and manages to.
Nice play.
Nice bounce pass down low. Allie Schulman, layup no good from Raftery. Now Lizzie Jenkins with the board, turnaround jumper no good. Mafior with the rebound. And she takes it the whole way, puts her head down, can't finish on the layup.
Good take, though. Got her teammates off the bench, rooting for her, get some points on the board.
Shulman driving. Great defense there from Lauren Hamm.
Good defense there by Ashley McDermott stealing the ball. Yeah.
Anticipation to steal. Mafiora drives. No good on the shot, but she draws the contact and will be shooting two from the stripe.
Good for Allie to good take right to the hoop. She got whacked in the arm and she's got two free throws. She's working hard out there.
First free throw, no good for the senior guard.
There you
Second
go.
Second one. Takes its time, but finds its way through.
It's a hometown bounce, and good for her.
49-12 lead now. 5.5 minutes remaining. Tough defense over by the baseline. Getting out of it is Collins. She gets the ball back down low, looking for help now again. Jenkins tries to throw it inside to Raftery. Ball bounces around. Collins in her hands. High shot, no good. Rebounded by McDermott.
Ooh.
Looked like a carry there
it did.
On him.
It
but
did, but.
Luckily there, no call. Mafiora down low, trying to muscle her way in.
Nice
pass to McDermott. Wide open in front of the hoop. She can't finish. Now in the hands of Allie Shulman.
5 minutes left, 49-12.
Collins with the baseline shot.
Nice box out.
A bit short and grabbed by McDermott. Gladue with a nice move. Can't finish on the shot, a bit short, but did a great job of getting it off. Shot by Shulman. A bit wild there, but she does draw the foul.
Fouls on Lauren Hamm, senior guard. Got her money's worth on that one. There's definitely some contact there. And I can't tell this girl's number.
23. Allie Shulman.
There we go.
Her first free throw. Misses the mark.
Boy, I don't know what the Hiller record is for lowest score. Lowest points allowed, but we're in that neighborhood.
I would imagine, yep.
Four and a half minutes to go in the game, and it's 49-12, Hillers. That's just an impressive defensive showing by the Hiller girls.
And to think it was 10-4, I believe, Hillers at one point. So really over the past 3.5 quarters, they've just been shutting down Dover-Sherborn. McDermott
unlucky there.
Fires the shot off inside the lane. No good there. Grabbed by Shulman. Great play there by Hamm to get her hands on the ball, force a jump ball. This one stays with the Raiders, though. Federico gets it inside to Raftery. Her shot up, no good. But she grabs her own rebound. And another jump ball there. This one goes to Hopkinton. Hamm from three, off the mark. Gladue with the board to Mafior, puts her head down.
Nice.
And one, Allie Mafior, the senior, gets a big rise out of the bench and she converts the shot and will look to make it a three-point play.
She's working hard and she earned that one. She got fouled clearly and muscled the shot up, and somehow it found its way through the hoop.
Free throw no good, but grabbed by Ham. Knocked out of bounds off of a Hiller. It looked like it should have been off of Dover-Sherborn, but no call there. And now Schulman will take it up the court for the Raiders. 3.5 minutes left, 51-12 advantage for Hopkinton. Lead just seems to keep getting bigger and bigger no matter who's in there for Hopkinton. Drive by Schulman, wild shot. Bailed out by a foul call.
Ashley McDermott moving with a Dover-Sherborn player, Allie Schulman. And again, not much he can do on that one. She just created some body contact and two shots for Dover-Sherborn.
Her first free throw is good. Caitlin Murphy enters into the game again for Dover-Sherborn. Tara Raftery takes a seat.
Nice shot.
2 for 2 from the line on that trip. Dover-Sherborn's first points of the fourth quarter. Matthew Orr, the nice pass to Gladue. She kicks out to Ham, now back to Prawl. Over to Gladue, back into McDermott. She turns around, fires, a bit too strong. Always fighting for the rebound is Mafior. Can't get it, now in the hands of Federico. It's like an illegal screen there on Colleen Doyle. Turnover for Dover-Sherborn.
Little hip check. Well illustrated by the referee, kind of giving his own version of what happened with his hip check. I hope he didn't pull his hip out there on that move, but it was sort of an illegal moving pick, and he got it right there. So, passed out. Pass went into the stands, not by design, of course. Ball goes back to Dover-Sherborn.
No lucky fans going home with any game balls here tonight. We don't have that many extra.
Good defense by the Hillers.
Prawl gets her hands in there. Somehow Federico comes up with it. Kicks it over to Doyle. Makes up for that last foul. Draining the nice jumper.
Nice recovery.
Yeah, Gladue does a great job of saving it. Mafior files cross court. Not quite enough on that pass. Corralled by Doyle.
1-on-3.
Federico fires the three off the front rim, just a bit short. Diana Regan with it. Great play, knocks it. In an effort to save it, knocks it off of a Hiller leg. Dover-Sherborn retains.
Dover-Sherborn with two freshmen, a bunch of sophomores, and a few juniors. They're just a young team, and that's their main roster. And then in the case of the Hillers, they have,
mostly juniors and seniors.
Yeah, and just really, really strong. And then some of the JV players. I believe that's what happened with Ashley McDermott and Libby Gladue. So probably playing 10 or 12 deep tonight,
right,
for the Hillers. And they haven't exactly scored a whole bunch of points in the second half, but again, they don't have their A team in it, but to the credit of all the players, they're playing really hard. And this half has been fairly even score wise so that after the big halftime lead, it's sort of been pretty steady since then.
Free throw drops in there. 51-17 now. 1:20 remaining. Hopkinton looking to improve. Will improve.
Nice shot.
Nice 3-point shot there from Lauren Hamm, the senior. Hopkinton will improve to 10-2 overall, 10-1 in the TVL, setting up a big showdown in Medfield on Friday at 6:30 as the top two teams in TVL will square off. And I kind of wish that one was here because I want to do that one, but we'll see. We'll see how the Hiller girls there do on Friday.
Yeah, I have to check my schedule. That might be a road trip.
Three-point shot goes off of McDermott's leg. Dover-Sherborn keeps possession. 45 and a half seconds left. Referee was just checking something, not quite sure what.
Bonus. No. Well, both teams are in bonus. In fact, Dover-Sherborn's in double bonus, but we have 40 seconds left in the game, so.
Maybe he was making sure his dinner order was all set. For
maybe the takeout order.
Three-pointer from Hams.
Oh, man.
He knocks it down again.
Boy, what was really kind of icing on the cake is the net was stuck up.
Yep.
From her previous three-pointer, yep.
And she cleaned that up.
Oh,
too.
Man, that is beautiful. She'll be talking about that. I'm sure her teammates will be
give her some props for that.
Absolutely. That's a nice way to finish up with a couple three-pointers at the end of the game for her.
Turnover there as Federico loses the ball out of bounds. Again, this loss will drop Dover-Sherborn to 3-10, 2-7. In the TVL, losers of four in a row. Hawkinton will improve to 10-2, 10-1 in the TVL, again with that big game against Medfield coming up on Friday. And that does it here in Hawkinton. The Hiller girls taking a 57-17 victory.
Boy, 40-point victory, we kind of called it early, not that we...
Right, not that we're proud of it.
Had any kind of... any kind of special information, but you can just sort of see that was going to probably go that way, and it certainly did. But congratulations to both teams. They both played hard. It was really great to see a lot of players on the Hillers getting some playing time, especially the seniors, Lauren Hamm and Kate Hugh. Well, she's a junior, but
right.
Some of the players who don't get a lot of playing time. Definitely was great to see them. And I see two players on crutches on the Hillers, so I'm not sure who they are, but... But anyway, as you said, the big game on Friday night, and we're looking forward to the rest of the season. I'm sure we'll be back here for another home game in the next week or so.
All right, and the Hillers take the season series against Dover-Sherborn, taking both games this season. And just before we exit out here, I wanted to give our crew one last thank you. Producers John Ritz and Mike Tarosian, director Tom Dings, graphics Samantha Dings, on cameras Mike Tarosian, John Ritz, and Mary Arnott. Thank you, guys, and thanks for listening. We hope to see you next time.